What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be reacting to the third episode of That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime Season 2. This one's titled Paradise Once More. Interestingly, this show is continuing with episode 25, 26, 27. So this is technically episode 27, but I'm just going to call it Season 2, Episode 3, just because I don't have Season 1 on the channel, and it would look a bit weird to have a playlist start with episode 25. So that's why I'm naming it the way I do. Anyway, last time, Trade with the Animal Kingdom, we had successful negotiations between Tempest and Urizania, I'm not sure how to say their name, I'll be honest. But it looks like the trade's going to go well. We've assigned someone to it. That way we don't have to worry about ourselves, which makes sense. You delegate responsibility to those who have a better chance of or have more competency in that one specific field. And now we are going off to Dwargan to visit Garzelle again. Dwarves are back. That's where we met the Dwarven Trio and Kaijul. Was that his name? Kaijin, sorry. Not Kaijul. So we're going back there to have a checkup, I guess, and keep our relationship going there. It's been a very slow start to the season in terms of not a lot new has happened. We've just been kind of like filling in a couple of blanks and just settling in, reintroducing characters, and just, it feels like we are just going around and visiting all the characters we know that will be relevant in future plot points again. That's what this second season kind of feels like right now. And I do wonder if this season, since this is a split core season two, we're going to have one core now. We're going to take a break for the spring season, then we'll be back for summer with part two. At least that is my understanding of this. I wonder if this is going to have the same feel as the ReZero split core did, with the first half of ReZero kind of being just set up for the most part. Somewhat slow, but getting a lot of information set up and ready for the second half, which then becomes very, very intense. I wonder if they're going to do something similar here, or if we're going to have a very definite ending point for the end of the first core before we go into the second part. I wonder how that's going to be. On the cover art and stuff, though, that demon, I forget his name, but he was mentioned at the very, very end of last season. He seems to feature rather prominently. Was it Diablo? I think it is this Diablo character. They gave his name to Rimuru last time. So I assume we're going to introduce him at some point. I assume that is going to be the next arc. And we just saw, Clayman prepare another scheme. So maybe that's where Diablo gets involved and that's how we get into it. But we've also got Hinata to worry about as well, because she's going to be involved soon as well. So maybe it's going to be Hinata, then Diablo, or both of them at the same time. I don't quite know how it's going to be, but Paradise Once More sounds like a very, very chill episode title. But maybe I'm wrong. Maybe we'll have something high action. I don't know. I guess we'll see. Anyway, we're going to get into the episode. I don't really have much more to say on this show right now, so let's just get into it, I suppose. As per usual, these are time-based form reactions here on YouTube. If you want to see full picture-in-picture, you can go to my Patreon down in the description below. £4 a month gets you access to all picture-in-picture reactions I do, which is everything from this season, as well as the Patreon-requested shows and some of the backdated ones from last season. In the gap between this season and next, I will be posting some backdated stuff like It Invaded. I want to get that one back. I want to get Beaufory back as well. I have a plan to do with movies that is going to be coming up in February. So if you're a Patreon in February, stay tuned, because I'll have a post coming to you about that soon as well. Anyway, here on YouTube, we have to do time-based, though. So bottom left of the screen, see the time for the episode. I catch down 3-2-1 play. Then play, you start the episode, I start the episode, and we'll be in sync. We are watching this one on Crunchyroll, since that's who's licensed it this season. No logos or anything to start. We're just going to fade in. You can use screen flash on my face or the mic to tell when he's transitioning. That should help you sync it up. And with all that said, let's get into episode 3, shall we? In 3-2-1 play. All right, here we go. We're in Dwargan. Mm-hmm. Hi, Gazel. Straight into OP? Straight into OP. There she is, Hinata. I assume she's going to be the first main arc we deal with. We still haven't seen Milim yet, have we? Like, she features very prominently in the ED, but we still haven't seen her, I don't think, in anime for a while. He's free. I love that new outfit, by the way. That's pretty good. Also, is that Milim? I'm 90% certain that's meant to be Milim. Which may be why she features prominently in ED. I don't know. Here we go. Paradise once more. Yes. Fair. Makes sense. It's gonna get a bit awkward, isn't it? Yeah. Well, here we go. Yes. Just don't piss her off and you'll be fine. Yep. Of course she's the oldest, that makes sense. Yep. I'm so proud. Good sound. I assume they literally recorded someone pouring that. And that's where you fail. No. Does that mean Rimuru can never get drunk now? Oh, is that a cider? Indeed, we have. Now that's a lot of attention. Well, yes. Oh yeah, as if it was so simple to do. Yes. Well, he's gonna make a deal for it. He's gonna want to import some soon, I know. We haven't been there yet, have we? Of course. Maybe not fond memories of it. Wow. High praise. Okay. Greedy king, okay. Okay. Yep, he wants a lot. Oh no, she's sloshed. Oh no. Let's get her to bed, please. She gonna fall off the edge? Please don't fall off the edge. Absolutely sloshed. And she's out. Love it. Yes. Manuscript, okay. Aha, declaration of friendship, alright. I love the robe. Talk about pressure. That's what the manuscript was. Calm yourself, boys. Very good. It's pretty good. That's just Rimuru's style, though. That is true. Makes sense. That is very true. Yep. Oh boy. What do you mean? Oh no. The elf place, okay. Yep, okay. I understand what I mean by paradise now. Oh no. Oh boy, here they are again. Oh boy. Yep. How would he ever forget you? Oh, damn. They're good at their jobs. Yep. Yes. All right, the god, the brother. Kaido, that was his name, all right. Yeah. That problem's all right. Yep. He's showing off the ladies, okay. Wow. Oh boy. They're really good at their job. Really good. Yep. That was a bit much. Okay. Market research. That. Indeed. Yep, everyone's hammered. We carrying Gopta. Yep. I get the feeling they're going to be spotted already. Oh boy. Yep. Yobazo. Oh boy. Oh no, she's here as well. Oh no. Oh no. Oh boy. Run, fellas, run, run, run. Didn't get away. Didn't mean they would. I love them. Gobzo doesn't give a damn. Wow, it works. I can't believe that works so easily. Oh God, that's a death sentence. Oh God. Oh God. Yep. Yep. I love how that loops back around. He's got poison resistance, he'll be fine. Maybe. Oh. Aha. In Falmouth or whatever. Aha, OP character. There's one guy. Oh, damn. Mulan, okay. Okay. Reluctance in that. ED time? ED time. That was a good episode. All right, we get a preview or not? Next episode title, anyway. The Scheming Kingdom of Falmouth. All right. So yeah, we are going to be dealing with Falmouth next. Makes sense. We've just been introduced to it as a very important trade partner, so it makes sense that we're going to think about them next. So yeah, that is Mulan. That is the mage we just met. I feel like there's an ulterior motive for her associating with the hero. I feel like there might be a reason why she went to him, probably to find out the truth of what happened. Maybe. Maybe to get closer. I don't think they'd try to get close to Rimuru because the you wouldn't go about that way to get to Rimuru, I don't think. But she definitely has an ulterior motive beyond just wanting to help out the hero's party. Just a case of what that actually ends up being. Interesting. And yeah, Bester was my boy Kenshiro. It's nice to hear him again. Okay. Good episode. Fairly laid back still. But we are getting we're furthering progress here and there. Next episode, I think we're now going to be moving on to completely new content in the regards of like we're actually be meeting new characters and exploring a new place rather than revisiting other areas we've done. Like, I guess the Animal Kingdom in Eurasia, or Rosaria, or whatever the hell you pronounce their name, that technically was new, I suppose. Although that was just meeting the characters from there, not actually visiting their land. This one, we might actually end up visiting Falmouth. Don't know if that's the case yet. And again, Milim is surprisingly absent. But then again, she's meant to be absent, I suppose, in a weird way. Like, we haven't really spent much time in the kingdom, or in Tempest at least, and I don't think you'd want to introduce a demon lord to the negotiations with Rosania or whatever, the Animal Kingdom, and you definitely wouldn't take them to Dworgen, so it makes sense that we haven't seen much of Milim in the start. I mean, this was probably the first episode where she was even mainly referenced other than the ED, so I assume her time is going to come later in the season, especially if that is her at the end of the OP, as I suspect it is. I assume we're going to have a fairly important moment with her moving forward. I guess we'll see when that ends up taking place. So that's going to do it for today, guys. Thank you everyone for watching. Hope you enjoyed this one as much as I did. Leave a like if you did, and as well as your comments. They both help grow the channel out, as does subscribing to the channel. And you can see next week's episode, as well as the rest of the Winter 2021 lineup, you can find on my channel. A lot of shows this season, and a lot of really, really good ones as well. It's one of my favorite seasons in a while. Like, last season was brilliant. This might be just as good, if not better. So thank you everyone for watching. Until next time, see you guys later.